Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Joanna Butterfield, MBE, parasport athlete.
Please close your eyes for a moment and imagine with me. You're 14, playing rugby for your school. Crash. Bang. A huge tackle and you're lying on the floor, unable to move. You're in your 20s, speeding home from a party. For a split second, you lose concentration. Crash. Bang. The car's in bits and you're sitting there, unable to move. You're 65, going for a shower. A simple slip on the floor and the next thing you remember is lying in hospital, unable to move. You're a 30-something girl working for the army. Just normal. Routine tests discover a tumour on your spinal cord. 1 week later, after surgery to remove it, you wake up, unable to move. These are all real stories of people I met in hospital. It shows us that life is fragile. No one is exempt from the possibility of a life changing completely and irreversibly in a moment. You can open your eyes. 28th of January 2011. That date is impaled in my brain forever. The day I walked into an operating theatre and woke up paralysed from the chest down. The day my life changed forever. It would be easy for me to be sad and depressed, ask why me? But I'm not here to tell you that story. Today, on International Women's Day, my story is not one of sadness, but one of happiness and success. People ask me, what was that moment like, waking up paralysed? It's hard to explain, but for me, it's very matter of fact. I could change it, but I wasn't going to let it defeat me. I had a choice that day, and every day since, I still have a choice. To be angry for what I can't do and don't have, or to be thankful for what I do have, for what I can do, and for who I am. I choose to be thankful. Am I thankful that I'm a tetraplegic? No. But I'm immensely thankful for the opportunities that I've been given because of it. I love my life. I find myself sitting here talking to you today as multiple world, European and Paralympic champion. Sport gave me a reason to carry on, an avenue to be successful and achieve great things. I've travelled the world and met so many great people. I no longer hear the words, can't do that. You'll never achieve that. I now get to see the faces of kids light up as I share my story and flash a medal or two. It's taken a lot of hard work and dedication, and I still struggle, don't we all? But my message to you today is that many things happen in life that we cannot control and we cannot change, but we can control and determine our own actions and choices towards such events. I'm stubborn. I chose to never give in, not accept that you can't do that, and to take every helping hand and opportunity presented before me. There's been a lot, and you never know what lies behind that unopened door. I chose to take the tatters of a shattered life broken by injury, pick them up, mould them, and make them into something beautiful again. Thank you for listening.